Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do Luminar AI face retouching using the Face AI tools for slimming and adding light to the face. This is particularly effective when doing face retouching in group portraits. I'm Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor. I use my over 30 years of photography experience to help photographers like you improve your work right from capture in the camera through to the editing process and the final product. As a Skylum ambassador, I teach Luminar AI, and it's one of the tools that I use in my process. If you enjoy this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Let's get started. I've chosen this image of this rather odd mannequin for demonstration purposes today, just to show you that Luminar can recognize it as a face, even though it's not a real person. So the tools that we're going to be looking at in this video are in the portrait section. So scroll down if you're in the tools section until you see portrait and open the Face AI tool. So these first two sliders are the ones we're going to be looking at today, face light and slim face. So the slim face I'm going to show you first does exactly what it says. So one thing that I always recommend doing is to take the sliders all the way to extreme, see what they do, and then settle somewhere in the middle when you're doing your editing. As you can see, if I just turn this tool off, that it's literally squishing the face in and making it look slimmer. Right, so that's gone to the extreme of 100. I would probably never go to that extreme on an actual real person. Keep it a little bit more natural looking, but just slim it a little bit if they've got chubby cheeks or if it's a picture where the lighting is not particularly flattering. You can slim them a little bit, but don't get carried away. The face light slider is one that I really love, and I use this one a lot. So let's drag this one up to the right and see what it does. It's literally like you've turned a light on or added a reflector or a fill flash to the actual face, but it's not affecting the rest of the image. So I've created this image to be dark to begin with, just to accentuate how well this slider works to light the face. Make sure to stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to tell you another way that you can add light to the face. Let's see how this works on a photo of an actual person. I've already applied some eye retouching using the sliders down below in this eye section, including changing her eye color. So let me turn this one off just to show you what it's doing to her eyes. And now we're going to do the slim face. Remember, keep it subtle. And the face light. So once again, the overall image is really dark. So I've done that on purpose. I've actually darkened the image further than where I would normally go. You can see that's the before and where I'm at now. And now instead of using a vignette to darken the edges, I've darkened the whole image, and I'm actually going to light her face with this slider. So it's kind of a quick shortcut. Instead of using a vignette, try to target the outer edge of the image, darken the entire image, and just brighten up the faces. Now it's particularly useful, as I mentioned earlier, with a group portrait. Let's take a quick look at that. Once again, you can see that the overall image is a little bit on the dark side, and I've done that on purpose. So I've processed it a little bit darker than normal. Now I'm just going to use this face light slider and watch what happens. This is where the magic begins, because it's not just lighting one face, it's lighting all three of our faces. That's me on the right. So this is great for group portraits because then you can save this as a template and add the face light to almost any portrait and brighten up those faces immediately. I mentioned earlier that I would tell you about another way to add light to the face, and that has to do with more of the photography portion. When you're taking people pictures or doing portraits, make sure that you have light in the eyes. I talked about that in the eyes video. Make sure you watch that one. So that you have light in the eyes and you have catch lights. That's a reflection of the light in the eyes. To do that, you can use a reflector. A reflector is a great way to just bounce a little bit of light back into the face when you're on location. Just get a nice foldable, portable reflector that opens up, that's got white on one side, and then gold or silver on the other side. A handy tip and something small that you can carry with you in your bag. To continue learning, make sure to watch my other Luminar AI face retouching videos where I talk about the eyes and the mouth.